Hi, I'm Agent Bennett, and I'm going to show you how to track your cell phone data usage. Then I'll offer a few suggestions on how to use less, along with setting up warnings and limits to help you avoid overage charges. Those charges can be expensive if you have a plan with limited data. Fortunately, most smartphones have an easy way to help you track your usage so you can avoid going over your limit. However, if overage fees are a concern, you might want to consider a prepaid plan. We have a great video on that very topic. You can check it out using the link below. All right, let's get started. Here's what you'll need: a smartphone and your wireless carrier account info and login credentials. For this demo, I'll be using a Google Pixel 5. Keep in mind that depending on your smartphone and your carrier, these steps might be slightly different. Let's get started. Open the Settings app. Then tap Network and Internet and SIMs. This screen will show you how much data you've used in this data usage cycle. Oh, and here's a tip. Depending on your plan, your data cycle resets on a specific day each month. If you set your phone to match that date, you can get a better idea of how much data you're using during that cycle. To set your phone's date to match your carrier's, open Settings. Then tap Network and Internet, SIMs, and then Data Warning and Limit. Then tap Mobile Data Usage Cycle and choose the date that matches when your carrier resets your data cycle. When you've got the right date, tap Set. While you could just keep checking your data use through your settings, there's an easier way to make sure you don't go over. Your smartphone probably has a built-in way to notify you when you're close to your limit. You can easily set warnings and limits for yourself if you navigate back to the Data Warning and Limit screen. Use the Set Data Warning slider to warn you when you hit a certain data amount within a single pay period. Choose the amount of data by tapping on Data Warning and then entering your data amount in megabytes or gigabytes. When you've entered the amount where you'd like to receive a warning, tap Set. In addition to setting up warnings, you can go a step further and actually limit the amount of data you can use within a single pay period. Use the Set Data Limit slider so your phone will automatically turn off data if you go over a certain amount. Now tap the Data Limit option and enter the data amount that you don't want to go over. And here's another pro tip. Every now and then, the way your mobile phone tracks your data might be slightly different from how your carrier measures it. So it's a good idea to set a limit that's slightly lower than what your plan allows. Tap Set when you're done. If you're often surprised by how much data you're using, you might want to double-check your app settings. Some apps only use data when they're open or in the foreground, while others may also use your data even when you're not actively using them. To see which apps are using your data and when, go to the SIMs and tap App Data Usage. Here you can see which apps are using your data, how much they're using, and when. Tap on an app to see how much data it's using when it's in the foreground and when it's running in the background. If you'd like to limit the amount of data an app is using, use the Background Data slider to make adjustments. Just keep in mind that if you limit an app's ability to use data, it might not work as well. For example, if you limit an email app to not use data when it's in the background, you might not see notifications of new emails unless you actually open the app. If you would like to limit your mobile data use across the board, you don't have to go through every app individually. If you'd like most of your apps to only use data when you're using them, you can use the Data Saver. Here's how. From the Network and Internet screen, tap Data Saver. Then use the slider to enable this feature. If you'd like certain apps to run without limits, tap Unrestricted Data and then select the apps you want to run without limits by tapping on the slider next to the app name. You can also make it easier to turn Data Saver on and off. Just tap the Edit button in the Settings bar and add the Data Saver option. Now you'll see a Data Saver toggle on your Settings bar, so you can enable or disable this function easily. I mentioned earlier that sometimes your phone doesn't track data usage the same way your carrier does. So if you'd really like to be careful about your data use, you can check your account on your carrier's app or website to see the data usage that they're reporting. If you need help finding this information with your carrier, reach out to them for more specific support. And here's one last tip. One of the best and easiest ways to use less data is to make sure that you connect to safe Wi-Fi networks when possible, instead of relying on your mobile network. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, give it a like. If you have questions, leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more tech tips from Best Buy. Thanks for watching.